In today's video, we're introducing flying dinosaurs. If you also love dinosaurs, feel free to subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to share it with your dinosaur-loving friends.
Tapajara. Early Cretaceous. Height, 1.3 meters. Length, 4 meters. Weight, 7 kilograms. Piscivore. Easily recognized thanks to its unique appearance, Tapajara is a genus of pterosaur native to Brazil with a brightly colored crest on top of its head that could grow up to a meter in length, helping it to attract mates. Its wingspan of around 4 meters makes it one of the smaller pterosaurs. While the name Tapajara translates to old being, information regarding the history of Tapajara is limited, as only one confirmed specimen has been recovered thus far. The genus was first classified in 1989 by Alexander Kellner, and in the following years further fossils were unearthed that were initially classified as Tapajara. However, these bones were subsequently found to be new genera, named Tupendactylus. Tapajara existed approximately 110 M years ago during the early Cretaceous period, flying across the skies of Brazil and diving down into the water to grab fish, although some paleontologists believe it may also have fed on fruit, or even the carcasses of dead animals. Quetzalcoatlus. Late Cretaceous. Height, 5.5 meters. Length, 15 meters. Weight, 250 kilograms. Piscivore. The piscivorous pterosaur Quetzalcoatlus dates back to the late Cretaceous period and is considered to be one of the largest flying animals the world has ever seen, with a wingspan in excess of 10 m, roughly the size of a small airplane. The name Quetzalcoatlus stems from the Aztec god Quetzalcoatl, meaning feathered serpent. Quetzalcoatlus was discovered through chance by Douglas A. Lawson in 1971, while digging for sauropods at Big Bend National Park in Texas. Lawson's team unearthed a giant wing bone fossil. The bone was so large that there was much controversy over what animal the specimen belonged to, but Lawson was able to show comparisons to pterodactyl that confirmed it was, in fact, a new genus. This genus lived in the southern states of the USA around 66 to 72 million years ago and shared its environment with a range of other pterosaurs, as well as many dinosaurs including Triceratops and the fearsome Tyrannosaurus rex. Quetzalcoatlus remains have mainly been found inland, although this may be because remains were unable to be preserved closer to the coast. Gehalopterus. Late Jurassic. Height, 0.3 meters. Length, 0.9 meters. Weight, 3 kilograms. Insectivore. Gehalopterus is an aneurognathid pterosaur notable for its blunt snout and rows of sharp teeth. The genus takes its name from the Jehol region of Inner Mongolia that it called home and has a wingspan of around 32 inches. It dates back to the mid-Jurassic period, around 164 million years ago. This genus was first described in 2002 by a group of paleontologists including the world-renowned Su Xing, following the discovery a near-complete skeleton in the Dahugu beds of the Heifengu Formation in Ningxing County, northeast China. This well-preserved specimen allowed expert to learn about the genus in detail and reach strong hypotheses on how it lived. Gehalopterus lived in the forests of Dahugu, where the climate was warm and humid, with a rich variety of flora and fauna. Although most aneurognathids fed primarily on insects, Gehalopterus' relatively large size has led researchers to believe it may also have been a piscivore, using its small, sharp teeth to dart into the water and grab fish swimming near the surface. Barbarodactylus. Late Cretaceous. Height, 1 meter. Length, 4.5 meters. Weight, 15 kilograms. Piscivore. Barbarodactylus is a medium-sized pterosaur that lived towards the end of the late Cretaceous period, around 66 to 72 million years ago. This genus is distinct from most other pterosaurs in that it is part of the Nyctosaurid family, which rarely walked on land and was specially adapted for almost constant flight. It takes its name from the Barbary coast of North Africa, near to where Barbarodactylus was discovered. The genus was first described by a paleontological dig group in 2018 after they discovered a collection of fossils while studying the Karibga Plateau in Morocco. Their investigation unearthed not one but three new dinosaur genera, fellow nyctosaurids Alcyon and Submergia were also discovered during this period. In total, 5 Barbarodactylus specimens were excavated, and the Caribga Plateau remains the only location where this genus has been found. Morocco was home to various flora and fauna during the late Cretaceous period, with evidence on record of abelosaurs, sauropods, and many marine reptiles and fish coexisting. Barbarodactylus was a piscivore, darting into the water to snare fish with its long beak. Maridactylus. Early Cretaceous, height 1.5 meters, length 6 meters, weight 5 kilograms, piscivore. The pterosaur Maridactylus has a wingspan of around 6 m and is easy to recognize thanks to its unusual appearance. Its jaws feature curved crests on both the upper and lower sections and contain rows of sharp teeth. Native to South America, the genus is named after the Brazilian legend Mara, a mystical woman who transformed into a monster with large teeth. Maridactylus is one of the most recent dinosaur discoveries, with the first fossils unearthed in 2010, when a skull and several vertebrae were excavated from the Romualdo Formation in Serra, Brazil. The remains were classified as a new genus for years later by Dr. Renaud Bantin, although there is much more to learn about this dinosaur, as there have been no further finds since. Maridactylus existed during the early Cretaceous period around 110 M years ago, sharing its environment with fellow pterosaur Cirridactylus. It had a piscivorous diet, darting down into the ocean to grab fish before flying to nests up on the cliffs away from predators. Cirridactylus. Early Cretaceous. Height 1 meter, length 4.5 meters, weight 15 kilograms, piscivore. Cirridactylus is a genus of large pterosaur, with a wingspan of approximately 4 to 5 meters. Its long beak and thin, sharp teeth allow this piscivore to dip down into water and grab fish to eat, while its large eyes ensure it is always aware of any potential threats from nearby predators. This flying reptile's full name, Cirridactylus atrox, translates to Xera's lethal finger, a reference to the location of its discovery and its sharp talons. Although the exact details of its discovery are not known, the first acknowledgement of Cirridactylus as a new genus came in 1985 when fossil collectors Giuseppe Leonardi and Guido Borgomanero named the one artifact that had been found, a partial skull that was found in the Romualdo Formation, Brazil. Cirridactylus lived in South America approximately 110 million years ago, during the early Cretaceous period. Its diet of fish showed that it lived near to water. The females laid their eggs in tall trees and on cliffs, in order to protect them from predators. Dimorphodon. Early Jurassic, height 1 meter, length 1.5 meters, weight 2 kilograms, piscivore. The pterosaur Dimorphodon is notable for the size of its head, which is much bigger than found in similar pterosaurs such as Pterodactylus. Its name translates to two-formed tooth, in reference to the two sets of teeth it has, while Dimorphodon is one of the smaller species of pterosaur, weighing just a few kilograms and with a wingspan of around 1.5 m. This genus was discovered by paleontologist and fossil collector Mary Anning in Dorset, on the south coast of the United Kingdom, in 1828. It was initially classified as a new species of Pterodactylus, but in 1858 Anning's discovery, then known as Pterodactylus macronix, was officially classified as a new genus, Dimorphodon. Dimorphodon lived during the early Jurassic period, around 190-200 m years ago. It lived along the coasts of Europe and was a piscivore, roaming nearby forests to hunt for insects and small animals, although it may also have fed on carrion when it couldn't find any prey. Sungaripterus. Early Cretaceous, height 0.9 meters, length 3 meters, weight 2 kilograms, piscivore. Notable for its large, elongated skull and unusual curved jaw, Sungaripterus is a genus of pterosaur that lived around 130 million years ago during the early Cretaceous period. Sungaripterus' jaw narrows to a point and contains no teeth at the front, with a row of flat teeth at the back for piercing the armor of shellfish. The discovery of Tsungaripteris came in 1964, when Chinese paleontologist Yang Zhengjian recovered a partial skeleton from the Yungar Basin in the northwest of China. In fact, the name Tsungaripteris means Yungar Wing, and further investigation of the site led to the excavation of a more complete skeleton in 1973. Tsungaripteris preferred to live near shallow water and mudflats as it existed on a diet of small fish, crustaceans and worms, although it may have preyed upon smaller pterosaurs as well. Experts hypothesizing that this piscivore's strange appearance is an evolutionary trait designed to allow easy extraction of shellfish hidden in rocks. Geosternbergia. Late Cretaceous, height 1 meter, length 7 meters, weight 3 kilograms, piscivore. Geosternbergia is named after American paleontologist George F. Sternberg, who was the first to discover then genus. It is one of the largest pterosaurs, with a wingspan of over 7 meters and a long, tapered beak that can grab fish out of the water or be used as a spear for catching them. Geosternbergia is notable for the distinctive crest on its head, which it used to attract mates for reproduction. Sternberg extracted the first Geosternbergia fossils from the Niobrara Formation, Kansas in 1952. It was originally classified as a new species of Pteranodon, but further study led to its reclassification as a subgenus in 1971 and eventually a new genus in 2010. Geosternbergia dates back to the late Cretaceous period, around 85 million years ago, and lived in North America. It mainly lived near coastal regions and had a piscivorous diet, darting into the ocean to feed and steering clear of the apex predator, Tyrannosaurus rex. Cretaceous, height 2 meters, length 7 meters, weight 25 kilograms, piscivore. Pteranodon is one of the largest pterosaurs ever to have existed with a wingspan stretching up to 7 meters, and is easily recognizable thanks to the crest on the top of its skull, which it uses for display purposes. Although its diet consists largely of fish, Pteranodon does not have teeth, chewing its prey with its beak. In fact, its name translates to wing toothless. With over 1,200 known specimens, Pteranodon is one of the most well-known genera of flying reptiles. The first remains were found in 1870 by American paleontologist Othniel Charles Marsh in Kansas, when he unearthed numerous wing bones from the Smoky Hill Chalk member. Initially, the find was classified as Pterodactylus, but the 1876 excavation of a skull with no teeth confirmed that it was a new genus. Pteranodon lived around 80-85 million years ago during the late Cretaceous period, and is native to North America, particularly around the western interior seaway. It lived alongside its relative Nyctosaurus and the toothed bird Ichthyornis, and built their nests high up to avoid predators. Tropeognathus. Early Cretaceous, height 1.8 meters, length 8 meters, weight 20 kilograms, piscivore. The piscivorous pterosaur Tropeognathus lived in South America during the early Cretaceous period around 110 million years ago, and is one of the largest pterosaurs ever to have existed with a wingspan of over 8 meters. The name Tropeognathus means keel jaw and refers to the enlarged crests on its jaw, which the dinosaur uses to retain balance when diving into water to catch fish. Tropeognathus was formally named in 1987 by German paleontologist Peter Raumhofer, after his workplace received a pterosaur skull that had been excavated from the Romualdo Formation in Serra, Brazil. Additional fossils have since been found near to the site of its discovery, including a near-complete skeleton in 2013 missing only the tail and parts of the back legs. Experts believe that Tropeognathus lived along the coastline of South America, nesting high out of reach of predators and plunging into the sea and nearby lakes to catch its prey. It shared its habitat with numerous other dinosaurs, including fellow pterosaur Cirrodactylus. Yeah!
The above is all the content for this article. Which dinosaur is your favorite? Feel free to leave a comment and let me know. Don't forget to subscribe to me. Also, remember to share it with your dinosaur-loving friends. See you in the next video.